Hello viewers and aspirants, welcome to Shankar IAS Academy's special session in the series Cracking UPSC the Right Way. If you are someone who is going to attend Prelims 2021, which is happening tomorrow, then this video is for you. As you are aware, in the series of Cracking UPSC the Right Way, we are addressing the common questions and doubts that a UPSC aspirant has while preparing for the examination. So in the same lines, today we are going to address the issue of negative marking. We are going to see how to minimize negative marking and how to maximize your score in prelims. You have to remember that prelims is an examination where getting right answers is as important as avoiding the wrong answers. Why? Because in prelims we have 1/3 negative marking. This means if in a set of 4 questions you attend one question correctly and the remaining question incorrectly, then your net score will be still 0 only because of this 1/3 negative marking. So in this session, we are going to see a technique which will help you to minimize your negative marking and maximize your score in the prelims in the available time. And I have named this approach as a 3-round approach or a 3-fold approach. In this approach, we are going to process the prelims question paper in at least 3 rounds. Now let us get into round 1. Now in this round 1, anyway, you are going to go through all the questions. Now while going through the questions, you will come across those questions to which you know the answers with 100% surety. That is, you know for sure that the answer which you are saying is the correct answer. So to such kind of questions, we are going to mark the final answer in the OMR sheet. And along with marking the final answer in the OMR sheet, you are also going to take a pencil and mark a dot beside the question number or below the question number. So if a question is marked with a dot, then that means you have already attended this question and you know the answer to this question with 100% surety. Now, while going through such questions, you'll also come across the questions to which you know the answers with 50% surety only. So, for such kind of questions, you're going to take a pencil and mark those questions with a star. And remember, we are not going to mark the final answer in the answer sheet as of now. We are going to retain this question as it is. Now, then you'll also have questions where there is no marking of dot or star. We'll come to these kinds of questions in our round 3. So in the round 1, we are going to mark the answers in the OMR sheets to those questions to which we are 100% sure that the option which we have chosen is the correct answer. So with this, let us move on to round 2. Now in this round 2, we are only going to focus on those questions which we have marked with a star. Now these are the questions to which you are 50% sure of the answer. That means you have already eliminated 2 options. Let us take an example. Assume that there is a 2-statement question and the given options are option A 1 only, option B 2 only, option C both 1 and 2, option D neither 1 nor 2. And you know for sure that statement 1 is right. And here the question also asks you to choose the right statements. So in such a scenario, we know that statement 1 should be in the answer. So because of that, our option could either be option A 1 only or option C both 1 and 2. And we have eliminated options B and D here. So this gives you the 50% probability of attending this question correctly. Now in such a scenario, before marking the right answer in your OMR sheet, you are going to go through the statement 2 once again. And you are going to conclude whether that statement is right or wrong. If you are able to conclude it, then well and good. But if you still are confused whether that statement is right or wrong, then take an intelligent guess and take a chance and mark either A as correct or C as correct. Remember, here you are taking an intelligent guess and not a wild guess. And you are taking a calculated risk here. So prelims is a qualifying examination. That means marks in your prelims will not be considered for your ranking. And that is why it is okay to take a bit of chance. So we have come to the end of round 2 now. Now we have come to round 3. Now in this round 3, we are only going to go through those questions which has not been marked with a star or a dot. So let us assume you have some 20 to 25 questions in this category, which doesn't have a star or a dot. So that means these are the questions to which you have no known answers, or these are the questions in the areas which you do not know anything about, or you only know something. So in such types of questions, what we are going to do is we are going to take a educated guess or an intelligent guess. We are not going to take any wild guess because it doesn't help. But your bottom line is that in this round, we are only going to attend 10 to 15 questions. Because if it goes beyond 15 questions, then your chances of enhancing your negative marks is quite high. So we are only going to go through 10 to 15 questions and mark 10 to 15 questions in the final answer sheet using a well-educated guess. So with this, we have seen the 3 rounds. In the first round, we are going to attend those questions to which we are 100% sure. Then the second round, here we are going to attend the questions to which we are 50% sure. And the third round, we are going to attend those questions to which either we are 33% sure or the questions where we can use our intelligent guessing technique. Now, before implementing this technique, I want you to remember 3 factors. First one, practice this technique today itself, because tomorrow is prelims 2021 examination and you don't want to go in blind and use this technique for the first time in the examination hall. So practice this technique using a mock test or a previous year question paper. Secondly, wild guessing does not work. So always take an intelligent and educated guess. And the third and more important one, mark answers in the OMR sheet carefully without any hurry. Before marking the answer, make sure it is the answer you want to mark, because once you mark it, you cannot change it. So keep all these ideas in mind and implement this technique in tomorrow's examination. And I hope using this technique, you can maximize your marks in preliminary examination. That brings me to the end of this session. I wish all of you all the best, and I'll meet you in our next session. Thank you.